Stars were made. I knew the challenges that I would face or the circumstances that were going to come up against me so that I could be ready and prepared. And I feel like if I knew what was coming tomorrow, it might change the way I behave today. I feel like there's maybe things that I would do that would change, or maybe the way I would speak would be different, or... And so here we have Jesus in a room with 12 men. And Jesus, he had that knowledge. He knew exactly what was going to happen. He knew what was in front of him. He knew the price that needed to be paid. He knew that sitting in the room, there would be someone that would like the courage to stand up for him. There would be someone who would betray him even. He knew what the next day offered. And so with that thought, he knew that he needed to do something right now that would help us. See, I can't see my tomorrow. I don't know what tomorrow holds. I don't know what is in front of me, but God knows. Jesus knew, and so he was fully aware that we could do it. We could face these challenges. We could climb these great mountains. We could knock down these huge obstacles. He knew we could do it. If only we would remember him. If only we would remember him. He knew that there was nothing that we couldn't face on this earth if we would just remember him. And so he sat with these men, kind of reflective of a group of people just like us. And he saw into their future. He saw their tomorrow. He knew the struggle they were going to face. He knew the loss they were going to feel. He knew the pain they were going to suffer. But he also saw the great joy and celebration that was to come. He saw what they were going to see a few days later when they got to celebrate that he had conquered death. And he saw beyond that day, and he saw beyond that time, and he saw centuries and decades, and he saw you, and he saw me, and he saw your pain, and he saw your challenge, and he saw your trial, and he saw your obstacle, but he also saw the great celebration and the great joy that would come if you would just remember him. And so this morning, as we come together and we celebrate Jesus did on that cross, let's remember that it was for our today. It was for our today. It wasn't just a moment in time, it was for our today. It was to remind us that everything we face, all the things that we're challenged with, we can overcome it because of him. So this morning, as we receive the bread and we receive the wine, we are going to remember Jesus. Taking the bread, he blessed it, broke it, and he gave it to them, saying, "This is my body given for you. Eat it in my memory." You may take the bread. And he did the same with the cup after supper, saying, "This is the cup, the new covenant written in my blood. My blood has been poured out." Father God, this morning, we just thank you. We thank you that you have been with us in this journey through life. We thank you that you're here with us today. And we thank you, God, that you are in our tomorrow. And as you speak, I'm
Jesus, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart.
I'm Pastor
especially if this is your first, second, or third time here at Wave Church. We just want to greet you. We want to give you a special greeting. So, Wave Church, can we give it up for our guests this morning? We're happy to have you for being here. We are honestly grateful that you have chosen this Sunday to be here. And as you came in this morning, we know you would have been made to feel welcome, but you also would have been given a service guide. Everyone should have this. And in that service guide, there's some great information, things that you need to know about us as a church, because our hopes are and our desires is to be able to help you take those next steps in your journey with Christ. And in that, we want to be able to show you just kind of who we are, because what we believe is that this could be the last church you would ever have to visit, because you would have found home and you would be able to call this place home, and that is our hope. And so what we'd love for you to do is simply just fill out this card. It's our connect card. I'd love to draw your attention to it, and we'd love to get your information, get to just know you a little bit more. And here's the guarantee: there's a hassle-free guarantee, meaning we will not ring you 12 o'clock at night. No one's gonna be knocking on your door at weird hours in the morning or anything like that. All we're gonna do is simply send you one letter and just thank you for being here and allowing us to let you know just a little bit about us. And there's four things that you just gotta know about us. One, we want you to know God. Two, we want you to find community, which is amazing, because guess what? Community groups start next month, or this Monday. So come on, somebody who's excited for a community group. And there's silence in the foyer, so you don't have to leave without finding community. But we would also love for you to be able to discover your purpose, the things in which God has placed in and through you. We want to be able to help you through that. And also, in that, we want you to be able to make a difference. And so if you would, just simply fill this out, pass it. You can drop it in the offering bucket as it passes you on later in the service, or one of our amazing blue shirts, our host team, they are incredible. You can hand it to them or drop it in our welcome center this morning. Waiters, can we give it up for them one more time? Come on! So good, but hey, just so you know, one of those steps that we have is called our journey experience, and we want to be able to help you take those next steps in your walk for Christ. So maybe you're new here, or maybe you've been coming for a couple months, or maybe you've been here for centuries. Well, listen, it does not matter. We want you in on the journey. And what we believe, if you give us 4 weeks, everyone say four. 4 weeks, then we can help you discover the purpose that God has you and take those next steps in making a difference, not only here at Wave Church, but abroad everywhere you go. And we believe that. And so our journey experience actually happens right after this service at 10:30. So please, if you want to get in on a journey, make sure you experience that today. But hey, I think y'all been sitting way too long. And here's what we need to do. We gotta dismiss some kids in just a second. So I believe that our kids deserve some celebration as they go off and learn about Jesus. So can we sing it up real quick? Stand up to your feet. Let's dismiss our kids.
This is what you should experience every time you go to church: the presence of God in worship. You should should feel the sting of the conviction of the Holy Spirit, and he should feel the love of the Father all sandwiched in at once. Because God found you where you were, but he's committed to not leaving you in that place. He's committed to you making steps towards him on a daily basis. So we're going to pray for that today. The Word of God is going to impact our lives in a powerful way. I'm believing the Word's going to impact my life as I preach it this morning. But we're also going to pray for our Greenville campus, which is about to start their service in about 20 minutes' time. And so we're going to pray that our Greenville service has the most incredible encounter of God, that Sean preaches a great word, that we have people gathered, that people's lives are changed, that people get saved in our Greenville campus this morning. Can we do that? Now, I want you to be Father, we thank you for your word. Lord, your word says of itself that, Lord, it does not return to you void, but that it accomplishes that which you sent it out to accomplish. So, Lord, I pray you'll illuminate our path, you'll light our feet today. And God, in this moment, we take the opportunity to lift up to you our Greenville campus, Father, our brothers, our sisters in Christ at Wade Church Greenville. Lord, we're praying that they have an incredible day today. Lord, we're praying that the anointing of the Holy Spirit will be upon that service, Father. I pray for each and every single person that calls that campus home. Lord, let them fall even more deeper in love with you today. Let them be challenged by your word. Let them leave that place motivated to make a difference in their city. We pray in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. 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 Well, you can take your seats this morning, church. And as you take your seats, it was, today is Kody's very first time playing guitar. Worship leading this morning. She has been in the choir, she's been on backing vocals, she's been on front line, and now she's worship leading. So praise God. And Kody, I just want to let you know, man, this morning, I just sense that there's a call of God on your life to do something incredible for Him.
Yeah.
And you know what's pretty awesome is that you remind me a lot of me. You're tall and you're skinny. Well, I used to be skinny, but I'm still tall. And this is what I know about you, man. God takes the simple availabilities of our life to do incredibly powerful things. And I want to remind you that it was David who was a warrior. He was a man's man, but yet he was often found in obscure places worshipping not just him and a bunch of sheep. And I want to let you know that the great effectiveness in the things of God is built and is forged and is cultivated in what you do in private.
Yeah.
And so the thing that made David ready to be king was his availability in the secret places, was those private moments, was those when he turned his bedroom into a Bible college, those sort of things, you know what I mean? I want to encourage you, as you step into this gift of yours, as you step into being available to be used by God, he's going to use you in a powerful way. And I think today is just the beginning of the incredible music. So, you're awesome, we love you. I think that bass guitar is bigger than Megan, praise the Lord. But great things come in pint-sized packages. Can I get an amen? Praise the Lord, unless it's food, and that's just disappointing. So today we're going to round out our series called In the Beginning. And we've been talking about the fact that there's this notion out there that it's not